So I'm a high school student at Buckingham Brown and Nichols in Cambridge. I'm in a Ismaili Muslim, and I go to this thing called Jamaat Ganat, it's a prayer hall on Fridays. And one of our family friends, he often helps me out, or like I ask him questions when I have questions, because my parents are like immigrants, and he's gone to college here, and you know he has experience. So I said, you know, what if I wanted to get involved in computer science over the summer? What do you think I should do? And he said, Google professors and email them. Just Google them, and I'm sure they could use your help, you know, because they have so much stuff they need to get done. So I said, okay. I actually finished my first year of high school, and then I Googled, you know, math professors at MIT, math professors at Brown, or computer, like, work in computer science. And I emailed Professor George Kalliris in the design lab at MIT, and I was like, you know, do you need someone to help you out with anything at all? And, you know, I wanted to do something productive, and he responded and said, why don't you come to see Grant? I came over and I met Chris the first day, which was like a great opportunity, and he gave me a little mobile application project. Because at that point I programmed in Objective-C and Java, and did some mobile application development, and a little bit of like C++, or a little bit of Python. But he had this idea of collecting data through a phone with a temperature sensor. That's, I guess, how it started. Having the opportunity to work at MIT and work at such a cutting-edge research facility, and have like someone like Chris take their time to help me grow as a student, or and teach me new things, and in the form of these research projects, like, I'm just so lucky. I'm like, oh my god, you know, I have to do well, and you know, I have to be in all the time, because like not everyone gets that opportunity. That's the reality of it. After that first year, I said, you know, I'd love to be back if you'd have me back. And he said, absolutely. And so I think year after year, the projects have gotten a little more legitimate. And the summer after 10th grade, I did work with ROS, the robot operating system, because there's potential to port the AUV Labs ROVs over to a more modular system. This year, I worked with Mike DeFilippo to upgrade system autonomy in Rex 3 by deploying it autonomously on top of that unmanned surface vessel. The years I've been at Sea Grant, you know, at face value, you think, you know, it's experience in computer science, experience in research. I think it's much bigger than that. And Professor Kostas and Professor George Kalliris and, you know, the rest of the Sea Grant staff has been incredibly kind, and have, they, like, I reached out to them, but they've helped me so much to grow. I don't know a ton about like environmental science or ocean science, but I think the exposure at Sea Grant, you know, that something like computer science and strictly software, right, or theory initially, has turned into something more, right? You can see how it's applied in like in the design lab with Hassam, and you know, with Professor Kalliris, and like all the work they do with fluid dynamics, you know, seeing it applied to like ocean navigation and, you know, controlling invasive species, which I have no experience in, right? But that I know it's applied, and there are really great uses for it. But on the desk, you know, and thinking about ways to develop that are, you know, incredibly interesting as well. Like, I'm sure I want to study computer science and do research, but I think Sea Grant's given me exposure in outside of theory. It's like, you know, it's refreshing, I guess, to see theory applied. Yeah.